Good morning, my dear student. In this video, we will learn types of constraints. Before studying types of constraints, we have to study how to create a table in SQL. Create table command is used to create the table in SQL. See here one example. We want to create one table, student table, with some field. Okay, admission number, name, age, gender, place. What is the command? Listen here. What is create table. These are the keywords. Then student is the table name. Then you have to specify the column names, so you have to open the bracket, then write name. First field name is admission number. That admission number always in number, so you have to write integer. The next field is name always in alphabet, so you have to write the data type is character. How many character length? 20 character length maximum we can give. Okay, the next field is age always in number, so we have to take the data type as integer. Then next field is gender. We are mentioned male or female, which type? Character type. M for male, F for female, so you have to take a character length 1. Then next field is place always in alphabet, so you have to take the data type is char data type, maximum character length 10. Then next close brace semicolon. This is the way to create the table. When we are executing this create table query, it create a one table like this. Okay, what are the field will be there? Admission number, name, age, gender, place, with one table structure we will get. Clear? How to create the table? Did you get idea? All of you understand how to create a table? Now we will study that types of constraint. Before studying the types of constraint, I will explain one example. Okay. Suppose you want to make a study table. What you will tell to your carpenter? You are telling one drawer is need for keep the book. Okay, another one box is fixed in one place for the keep pen and pencil. Okay, another one place for keep the laptop, and that arrangement plug point all will be you are telling into the carpenter. According to that, carpenter will make. Like that, when we are creating the SQL table, that time also we can give the some instruction in the table. Okay, that instructions are given by the constraints. Did you get the idea what is constraints? Okay, in the create table query, we can only create the simple table, ordinary table, normal table we can create. If you want to special things we want to give, we have to use the constraint. Okay, constraint means ensure database integrity. Okay, integrity means honesty, reality. Okay, table reality we can get in the constraint. Okay, there are four types of constraints here: unique constraint, primary key constraint, default constraint, check constraint. Variety of constraints are there for your studies. Four constraints only they are: unique constraint, primary key constraint, default constraint, check constraint. Okay, first constraint is unique constraint. This constraint, no two rows have same value. No two rows have the same value in the specified field. Particular field, no two rows have the same value. That is a unique constraint. One example we can take, our class roll number. Roll number, anybody have same roll number? Nobody have same roll number. Okay, that is a unique constraint. Okay, unique constraint. How to create unique constraint in the table? Okay, we will see. Write the query. What is create table? Then table name is student student, open bracket, admission number. First field is admission number. Which type already we given? Integer. Admission number always number, so we are given the integer. Okay, then we are specifying unique here because of admission number, no one have same admission number. Okay, then admission number is unique, so we are set the constraint in the admission number unique, then remaining as it is. How we are given? Name is which type? Char data type. Of how many character length? 20 character length. Next one is gender. Gender is character length. How many character length? 1 character length. Next, age integer. Then next, place also which type? Char data type. How many character length we given? 10 character, close bracket, semicolon. Okay, this way we can create the unique. In the above example, admission number is taken as unique because of no two students have same admission number. Clear unique constraint? Okay. Next constraint is primary key constraint. It is used to uniquely identify the record. One example we can say Aadhaar card number. Okay, in our India, how many peoples are there? All are have the which one? Aadhaar card number. Anybody have that same Aadhaar card number? No, nobody has that Aadhaar card number, same Aadhaar card number. That is a primary key. Using Aadhaar card number, what we have to do? We can correctly identify the person. For that purpose only we are using the primary key. Primary key is used to uniquely identify a record. Clear? Here, unique and primary key constraint both are same, but only one difference. Unique constraints we can apply in more than one column, or more than one field. Okay. But in the primary key, we can apply in only one column. That is the difference between unique constraint and primary key constraint. Did you understand? Come to an example. Create table student. Then next field name, admission number. We already mentioned integer admission number. Always we are writing an integer. We are set to the primary key in this field, admission number, primary key. Okay. Then next field is name. We already mentioned character. How many character length? 20 character length. Next field is age. Age is always in number, so integer character we are giving integer. Next one is gender. We are represented by data type char. Then character length is 1. Then next one is place. Next field is place. Place is character data type of length 10 character, close the bracket. Okay. Same way only we are creating, but in the primary key we set in a field admission number. Okay, clear? In this example, admission number we set as a primary key because of nobody have that same admission number. So we are set the primary key in the admission number field. Okay, clear? Next constraint is default constraint. This constraint is used to assign a default value for the field. It is used to assign the default value to the field. That means if we are not given value to the field, this default value will be set into the field. See here, now we are table created. What are the table field are there? Admission number, name, age, gender, place value. In this situation, admission number we are giving 1001, name, Abhi. Okay, then age 16, then gender male. Okay, place Chennai, like that we are giving. When we are giving like that, that field is completed. whenever we are not enter any field value is not entered, that time it will take automatically take the default value. Now if you are entering the 12th standard student, means their age limit is maximum 17. Most of the students will be age is 17 only, so we can default value set for the age field 17. No need of enter each and every time 50 students, no need to enter the 17 17 17. Once we have set the value for the age field 17, so automatically 17 50 student age will be automatically inserted into 17. Some changes, some students have maybe 16, that time we can change it. Okay, that is a default value. Did you clear? To set the default value in the field, okay, using the example, same example only we are taking. Create table student, then what, admission number, integer, okay, integer, then next name is which character type, char data type of 20 character length. Next one is age is integer. We know that default value, so you have to set the default equal to 17, default equal to 17, comma gender care of 1, comma place care of 10. Okay, close the bracket, semicolon. Okay, in this above example, age field value is set as a 17. Okay, whenever we are entering the value, if we are missing the age field value, it automatically set by 17. Okay, clear? Next constraint is check constraint. Check constraint also same way, only default. Okay, what is it? It is used to check the limit. We can say enter the value till this. Okay, we know that already, previous example only we will take the 12th standard student maximum age limit is 17 only. Okay, we can give that 17 age limit, 17. The 17 or less number only we can enter in that particular field. That is a check constraint. Come to the example, how we are creating. Create table student admission number integer, then next name is char type, how many character length, 20 character length, then next age is which type, integer type. So we have to give the check constraint. Check equal to less than or equal to 17. Okay, less than or equal to 17. Then gender care of 1 character length. Then place care of 10. Then close bracket, semicolon. Okay. In this example, we can enter the value in the age field less than or equal to 70. Above 70, we can't enter. That is the meaning. Okay. There are two more constraints also there. Table constraint and column constraint. Both the same. Table constraint means we can apply the constraint for more than one field. We can apply the constraint more than one field is called table constraint. Then column constraint means we can apply the constraint only one column at a time. Did you understand types of constraint? Easy only. Okay, bye bye, study well.